Good evening and welcome to Olde Tyme Taunton. I'm your host, Charlie Crowley, and tonight, like we do every week, we talk about our community and hopefully generate a greater amount of interest and enthusiasm in our city and hopefully a greater appreciation. That's what our goal is here. It has been our goal ever since we first started this back in July of 1998. We're here live from our studios here on Ingle Street tonight. And this is well over 300 shows, but tonight we're going to do a special program on the rivers of Taunton. The Taunton River, the Mill River, and the 3 Mile River. And we're going to show you some of the mills that used to be along there, some of the fishing that took place there, the shipping that was along there, all kinds of things, all about the rivers of Taunton tonight. And you're welcome to join us here. The number to join us and call in, 774-501-1756. That's all it takes here. If you've got a question or comment, please feel free to do that. And just a reminder, these I do every week here from our studio. I also do programs out in the community, and it's all volunteer. It's all volunteer here. But if I do a program and your community wants someone, your group wants somebody to do a presentation before them, I'd be happy to do it, provide my schedule permits to do that for the group. There is no cost to that. It's all volunteer. I'd love to do it on any topic dealing with Taunton and its history, so just keep it in mind. But tonight we're going to talk about the rivers of Taunton, and one of the postcards, if you collect postcards, you've probably seen this image around. This is one of the postcards of the herring that was very plentiful in our city. And matter of fact, we were called a herring town for many years. Of course, now a silver city, but at one time we were called a herring town because the fishing industry in town was very, very popular and very, very prosperous over the years. So when you look at a map of the city at one time, it shows you Dighton, Berkeley, and so forth. And the rivers really are at the heart of this community. But if you look at a little bit close at some of those, we'll do that. You can see where this old map from the 1700s shows a lot of the people who lived along the rivers. It was the main transportation route. And you'll see some names along there, handwritten landing places. And there were several landing places in town. And that's where the centers of activity took place, business activity. For example, right there would be the intersection right at Neckerland, where the Mill River, what we know now as the Mill River and the Taunton River, or the Teticut River, actually connected. That's where it is. And if you look at this particular aerial picture, the road that's coming down from the bottom going up, that's High Street. And it intersects with Summer Street coming from left to center. And then from the center going over towards the right, that is what we know now as County Street. But the right there, you can see how the Taunton River snakes down. And it's quite a unique area. And that is where the landing place was originally. It's just up the Mill River. Because there was no bridge at what we know now as Ingle Street. Because the ships could come up all the way from Mount Hope Bay, all the way up through the Ware Village, and actually continue all the way down to East Taunton. But they could go up to the Mill River for a distance. As a matter of fact, the area right where the gas station was for many years, and those gas tanks are now that you can see there at the intersection of Ingle and Summer Street, that was a very popular business area. The business area was not in what we know now as Main Street. It was actually here, right at Neckerland. And then we want to look at the second landing place. Landing place number two was right where that dot is. And that is over near across the street from the Girls Club. And if you look at that's the Taunton River and the railroad bridge that you can see in the center. That's Dean Street going left to right. And then from the center going north, that's Arlington Street. And that's where the landing place was, the second landing place. And there were actual boathouses there in later years, but that was a landing place where people could bring their lumber or their materials, their products for delivery to points along the river, or to a mill, for example, to be able to be processed. That's another, if you look down here, there was another right around on Ingle Street. You can see that road going from the center over to the left. That's High Street. And that is right where Gray's Boatyard used to be. That was a third landing place in Taunton in colonial days. Then you've got another place way down here. I'll show you, that's the Weir Village. And you can see the East Water Street coming there. And you got the sewer treatment plant over on the left. So it's across the river on the east side of the Taunton River. That's where another landing place was. And then you have another one at the mouth of the 3 Mile River, where it intersects with the Taunton River. So we'll show you that. There they are. So there's all kind of places here. But this is what the neck of land looked like. And this was a center of not only commercial activity during colonial times, but as time went on, it became more for recreational boating. So the boating that you see here in this postcard actually shows recreational boating. Now the river to the left, that's the Mill River. The river going up towards the right, that is the Taunton River as it continues over underneath that bridge. And that's the bridge on County Street, just to get yourself oriented. You can see there is a boathouse there. Perhaps you have a question or comment about the rivers of Taunton, 774-501-1756. That's all it takes to join us here, have a question, maybe a comment, what you'd like to add about the river. Maybe you've navigated the rivers and want to tell us about your story about it. But the neck of land, where is the neck of land area? And if you're coming down Summer Street from the city, and you get to the point where you go right to Ingle Street on left to County, that is neck of land. And this is, you'd probably see this house. That house is on what was called Neck of Land Park. It was an actual public park owned by the city at one time. And this shows you from the riverside looking at it. The part to the left is the Mill River, and of course, the Taunton River to the right. But you can see the walkways they had there and some benches that used to be on that property where this is today. So that'd give you an idea. But that's called Neck of Land Park. So you can see where it got its name, Neck of Land, right there, because that's right where the two rivers join. And they had taverns there. They had, matter of fact, the Marquis de Lafayette actually stayed here, right at Neck of Land, in the Wilmot's Tavern that used to be there. And that's where the road used to be. When you come down from left going towards center, that's Summer Street, it actually stopped there and you took a left where this red is. And that's the old road. And when they straightened straightened the road, that's when you saw where the bridge is now going over. And then where the Mill River is, there was no bridge prior to the Revolutionary War. There was no bridge there crossing the Mill River on Ingle Street. In order to get to High Street, you had to go, Ingle Street, you had to go down what was called the Old High Street, or Crooked Lane. There's another area taken right around near Neck of Land, near the Neck of Land Bridge. A lot of recreational boating in the area. Perhaps you have gone up and down the rivers in a boat or a canoe or something like a kayak or something like that. Tell us your experience. What did you think it was like going down the Taunton River? Because this was a very, very important artery in the city, not only for transportation, but for fishing over the years. And we're going to explore tonight all the rivers. So join us here. My name is Charlie Crowley. We're going to get into it and why it's so special. Because I can tell you that there used to be ships in the river, but until you see them, you will, which you'll see tonight, bring your kids to the television tonight. Let them learn a little bit of Taunton. I'm convinced the more you know about Taunton, the more you'll love it. There's another view looking at, this is from, if you're in a boat on Taunton River, opposite Mill River, looking up towards the County Street Bridge, that's what you'd see. And you can see Nam written on there, different the Taunton, all these recreational boats that were there. That's the boathouse that was right next to the Neck of Land Bridge. The Mechanics Cooperative Bank would be to the right. That's County Street Bridge, the old County Street Bridge that was there before. We showed you where the old, one of the old landing places were. This is Townsend's Boathouse on Dean Street. That's right opposite the, roughly where the Girls Club is today. That was a popular, about 1888 or so, this one. That wasn't the only one there, but that's another, the old boathouse. And this was taken down many years to replaced by a more modern boathouse. This is the Taunton Boat Club. This is looking from that railroad bridge on Dean Street, right near the Girls Club, and looking back towards the city. And you can see the actual boat club. Maybe you remember the boat club or your parents talking to you about it. That's where the boat club used to be. If you're coming down Dean at the corner of Prospect Street, that is the Grandmont, what was the Grandmont House, and that's where the Taunton Boat Club used to be. And if you look, that's the Taunton Boat Club. Looking, the Dean Street would be, and Prospect Street would be on the other side of the of this building. This is the river side of that. They used to have all kind of night, at night during the summer, they used to have boating excursions going up and down the river. They'd have Chinese lanterns all outside on the dock. Very, very popular on a summer's night to go recreational boating on Taunton River. That's looking from the railroad bridge, looking back towards the city. And you can see the, and this is where the dock that you see here on the right, in the foreground, that is where Townsend's Boathouse used to be in that area. This is Congdon's Boathouse. This was actually on the other side of the railroad bridge going away from the city. If you were to come down Dean Street, you cross over the railroad bridge on the right, not quite before you get to the Long Meadow Nursing Home. Walter Fletcher used to own this particular boathouse. He used to rent canoes there. Perhaps you remember that when you were growing up, or your parents talking about it. Just to give you an idea where it is, this is an old insurance map of Dean Street. And you can see the pink building there. That is the old Dean Street Railroad Station. Now it's the Taunton Retirement Board. Its offices are there. It's where Goff's Masonry used to be. But just to show you, that's Congdon's Boathouse right there. And that big one you see to the right, that is where Hotshot House, where Long Meadow Nursing Home. But that's the boat club. Then we'll show you that building there is this house, the Witherell House, and that is the Long Meadow Nursing Home, the original Long Meadow Nursing Home that was formerly the Hotshot Estate. Perhaps you lived on that street and admired some of those properties in that area, maybe some of this curiosity things as you go around the city as they relate to the either the Taunton River or anything else. Just give us a call, 774-501-1756. That's all it takes to join us here tonight on Olde Tyme Taunton. We're talking about the rivers of Taunton. We're going to go and concentrate on the Taunton River at first. Then we're going to go to the Mill River, and then we're going to go to the Three Mile River. And you'll know after tonight why we call the Middle River in Taunton, the Mill, M-I-L-L, River in town. But of course, with rivers, you have flooding. And this was the flooding that occurred in February of 1886, the St. Valentine's Day flood. And it really caused a lot of havoc in the area near Summer Street. Whoops. Maybe if you try us back again, you'll be able to get through. It was tough being able to do that. Let me see if I can get that. Okay, here we go. But this is looking towards where J.D. Furniture used to be, looking towards Dean Street. Now, the way in the background here would be Dean Street, and you can see the railroad tracks emerging out of the water. It's all flooded because the Taunton River just wound around here. Just give us a call back here, 774-501-1756. We had somebody call a minute ago, but for some reason, I got disconnected here. But this was the flood of St. Valentine's Day in 1886. Also along the river, you had the what was known as originally as the William Street Bridge. It later became known as the Harris Street Bridge, named for Henry Harris. That's still there. You can't go over it anymore. But this was built solely not to get from people from one side of the river to the other, but it was built for the strict purpose of supporting the pipe, the water pipe, that's coming from the pump station over towards Dean Street. And this is a picture of them putting it in. And you can see the work that's going in on the building the Harris Street Bridge. It would be right across from Pub 99, for those of you new to the area, trying to orient yourself. But that's no OSHA guidelines back at this time. This would be taken probably about 130 years ago, almost 125 years ago, actually. And that'd be right across at Pub 99. That's what you'd see. You're next in Olde Tyme Taunton.
How are you doing, Mr. Crowley? I'm just looking at the picture of the bridge that you have there on Dean Street. I remember crossing that bridge as a young kid and my aunt when we used to come up and visit Taunton. Now I currently live in Taunton. And I think it's great that you're showing pictures of the old Taunton River and river revitalization that they had back then. And I'm wondering if they could possibly bring some of that back.
Well,
Providence doing with the water fire and all of that type of thing.
Well, that's been recognized. It's being slowly cleaned up, the river is. And who knows whether they'll have the fire in there, but boating, recreational boating, would like to be able to increase that. A few years ago, they had a tour boat on down at the Ware Village and a canopy top on it. There was a gentleman from down in Florida. He brought it up. So I actually got to ride on that boat because he wanted me to narrate the historical landmarks along the river. And we'd go from the Ware Village all the way down to Bristol Aggie and then come up. And sometimes we'd go all the way up to this particular bridge, depending on what group we had with them. And it's just extraordinary when you go down the river, how beautiful it is. You know, I expected to see shopping baskets and things like that, but you really don't. It's really nice.
Yeah, it is really nice on the river. Another comment I wanted to make, I know they're doing Murray's Bridge right now and the Murray's Bridge Dam. And I was wondering, seeing as all the mills used to run on like electric power and whatnot, could they possibly put like some type of generator into that dam to generate electricity or
something in that line? They explored that back a few years ago when I was mayor. We met in Boston regarding that. The TMLP looked at that. But the amount of power that you'd generate over a course of an entire year could light four houses. That's all because of the height of the dam was not that significant. Because originally the Mill River there was no pond there. There was no lake there as we know it. And what it is, there was four gentlemen. One was named Samuel Crocker. There was Charles Richmond. There was Thomas Bush and another gentleman. They got together and they created they would call it a Taunton Manufacturing Company. They erected four dams on the river and created what we know now as Sebatia Lake. It was called Scanning Pond. They created that to create enough water power to power the mills that those gentlemen built along there so we could compete with Lowell and Lawrence like that. So it's not that long, but what they're doing now, they're going to be putting in a new bridge at Murray's at Bay Street, but also a new dam. They're not going to be one and the same. It's just going to be up where that coffer dam was, and they'll have a fish ladder. Now, if you're coming up, the fish can come up the Mill River now only as far as right behind After Hours Auto Body. There used to be a series of dams lower on the lower Mill River near TMLP and near Washington Street. There was a big dam there. But now they can go up to where it used to be Hopewell Mill, which we'll see a picture of behind After Hours Auto Body. And then you've got Reed and Barton, there's a dam there. They're in the process now taking that dam down behind After Hours Auto Body. The only obstacle left would be Reed and Barton dam there, and then the pile of rocks that were left over from that. The dam crisis in 05, they just put a pile of rocks at Whittington.
Yeah, I know. I worked in the building right there adjacent to the dam and kind of saw it all happening.
Those are up, then the herring in the springtime will be able to go all the way up and into Sebatia Lake.
Right, like they used to do, and I think that's a fantastic idea.
So the best part of it in working that plan out was that the end result is there was no cost to the city of Taunton to put the dam in and the bridge, other than some temporary easements as they're working. But it's all it's paid for by the state. It's a what they call a TIP program.
That kind of surprised me because I thought the dams actually were operated still by the mills and owned by the mills.
Well, they were owned by the gentleman who bought the Whittington Mills, and he bought the property. And I'm not saying he didn't know that that was part of it. He's smart enough to know that. But that really wasn't his primary interest. He was acquiring the property, and unfortunately, he had two dams, the Maurice Bridge Dam and the one at the Whittington Dam, right at the mill site. But they had a problem with it because he didn't have to maintain it. All he did is, if he maintained it, he had to do it by their guidelines. But clearly, he could just take it out. And if he'd done that, then the entire lake would have emptied out into downtown, and you wouldn't have had Sebastian Lake anymore because it was man-made. So they had to treat it with kid gloves. To basically, they punished him for certain things he did. But they basically took over and decided it's in the community's best interest and the environmental interest to have a dam there, so the state is actually funding that.
Oh, okay.
All righty.
I know the state had tried to take it over before, or the previous owner had asked the state to take it over, and they said he was doing such a good job maintaining the bridge and the water levels, because at one time, people at Sebastian Lake, they had, like, the lake was down to nothing, and he says, hey, I have to supply water downstream. And he had a whole booklet on how it ran and how to keep it, and what he had markers showing the water levels and going up and down the Habermas Swamp.
Right.
We do the runoff and say, okay, if it's this, then we do this. And he had, you know, a whole history of the dam setting. And I think when the new owner came in, he just left the dams alone and just didn't really go follow those guidelines.
Yeah, the Oakham family is the one that owned it. Right. They're the ones who monitored it and did a pretty good job. It's the person, Murphy, who owned it after him, and he only bought it 04, somewhere around there, just before the dam crisis.
Right.
All righty.
Pleasure talking to you, sir.
Hey, thank you. Thank you very much. That was a little bit about the Mill River, and we'll be getting to that. This is the pumping station, built around 1876, and this supplied potable water to the citizens of Taunton back at that time. For not only for drinking, but also for fire protection. Then when you get down the Weir, this is looking down the street on the bottom side of the river. That's East Water Street. And up above, you can see where it says West Water. We had a lot of businesses around there. But that's what it looked like if you're standing on the bridge looking up in recent times. And then looking at the dam. That's the current bridge. But that's an old picture of one of the older Weir bridges. And that's taken from the West Water Street side, looking across the street. The building to the left that you see in the background, that's where the Atlantic Cafe is today, the Rhodes Tavern. This is looking at the bridge around 1903. As you're approaching, you're standing in front of probably Jimmy's Barbershop, looking across at the bridge. And all that area where you see to the right with those buildings, that's where William Walker Park is. J. Paul and Company, John Paul, he went out to, during the gold rush, struck it rich and came back with his winnings and built a grain company here in Taunton. If you're on top of the old Robinsons by the river looking back towards the Weir, you can see the old turnstile bridge. What it would do is if your ship came up to get by the bridge would turn. And so it, instead of going from left to right, as you see it, it would be going north-south, so that you could actually get through those channels. And they'd turn around right here in the foreground and turn and go back in the other direction. But they would be tugged up. They would not sail up the Taunton River. This is looking from behind Robinson by the river, looking downstream. The area that you see to the left would be the backyard of the Atlantic Cafe. And you can see a close-up of the turnstile bridge. This was taken out around 1953. Another postcard view of that. And they're there in the... this is a Calvi photograph trying to take that out. Emmett Calvi took this. They were in the process of putting the new bridge, and that's Senator Parker to the right, and in the then also Mayor Chamberlain is there as well. Joe Chamberlain, the mayor during the 1950s. This is the looking downstream, oh, probably 100 years ago, looking down Taunton River from the bridge. The grain companies would be immediately on the right. You've got looking down to where F.B. Rogers used to be on the right, and you got to see the schooners on the left, where Riverfront Park is today. But that's another the view, a postcard view of the ships at the Weir. This is all in Weir Village in Taunton. The ships actually came up to the Mill River to deliver the products to the raw products to the Weir Industries, and then bring the finished product to customers all along the eastern seaboard. So you got the area to the right, White and Warner Stove. That would be down beyond the TMLP, or right near the TMLP generating plant that you see there. And that would be right just beyond Fifth Avenue, or Fifth Street, I believe it is. That's a schooner trying to turn around in the middle of the river. The buildings that you see to the left are the grain companies that were right opposite the car wash, just to get you. That's looking up towards Ingle Street. This gives you an idea of what it looked like. This is a typical scene, probably where the F.B. Rogers building was. You can see three schooners in a row. The schooners would rarely come up with their sails up. They would be, from Dighton, there would be a tow vehicle bringing them up. They usually, up until about 1854, the ships were tugged up by via a horse or an oxen on the towpath. The towpath would be on the east side of the river. But from about 1854 up, they used the tugboats, and they would help navigate the river because there are various places in the river that were dangerous. The Needles, a place called the Needles, a place called Table Rock. They could rip your boat apart if you went over them, so you had to have an experienced person help you up. That's what they did. Once they get up to the Weir, and they'd open up the sails to dry them out, but they never came up the river in full sail. But these are just some of the views of the Mill River. Perhaps you have a question or comment, just like that previous gentleman, 774-501-1756. That's all it takes, simple as that. Give me a call. I'm Charlie Crowley. If I don't know the answer to your question, I will find out, and I'll answer it in a upcoming show. If you want to, we're talking primarily about the rivers tonight. And showing you what it looked like in yesteryear. So it's not that difficult, but you have a call. You're next in Olde Tyme Taunton. Hi. You're on the air. Go ahead, if you can turn your TV down, please.
Hi. Charlie, I have a question for you.
Sure.
Yeah, can you turn that down?
Yeah, because you're getting the feedback.
I'm watching your program about the history of Taunton River, and obviously it was very important for the economy and history of Taunton.
Sure.
But going forward, how do you see the river playing a part in Taunton's economy and history for future generations?
Well, I think that to take advantage of the natural characteristics of the river more for recreational types of activity as opposed to industrial activity like we had years ago, because it served dual purposes in the past, because they were going to actually make a canal from the Weir all the way up there. What we know now is the Cape Cod Canal. Actually, there was an engineered drawing of a canal planned for Taunton going up through Brockton to Boston, but it never came to fruition. But I would see that having recreational boating and tour boats and things around the Weir going all the way up and down between ourselves and Fall River would be, I think, real popular if they were done right. We've had a few of those, as I mentioned in the earlier call, because they asked me to help with the tours. And originally, what I was asked to do was to do the first tour so that the guy who owned the boat could learn about the river, and then he would do the tours. But he eventually, there was so much information, he couldn't remember it all, so he kept inviting me back. But I think that there's a lot of people, not from a historical standpoint, but from an environmental standpoint, I think having tours from different angles, different approach, I think would be an educational treasure for you know, you and I and our children to be able to learn the from all the species that are growing along the river, what's going on to try to improve the river, as well as some of the historical landmarks along there. There's a lot of ways you can approach that.
All right. Well, thank you very much. I appreciate your time.
Great. Thanks. But there's so much with the Taunton. Believe me, when I say this time and time again, they're probably sick of it. But the more you know about Taunton, the more you love it. We have an extraordinary history and a very promising future as well. But here shows you some tugboats. These are the tugboats I talked about. That's at what they call Staples Wharf. Staples Wharf was right behind where H&H Machine was in Taunton. And you have a schooner behind there. And these tugboats would actually pull them upstream, and they'd know exactly, the drivers would know exactly where the ship, the dangerous areas were. This is called Brown's Boat Building Shop, and this would be where phase two of Riverfront Park is. If you're down there where the playground is in Riverfront Park on the east side of the river, that is where Brown's Boat Building Shop would be. They'd make the ships along there. If you're looking from the river, looking up towards the weir, the gas works used to be where the scrapyard is, roughly, where the scrapyard is on West Water Street. Now, this is looking back towards the Weir Bridge. So this would be on the west side where the gas works was. The gas company used to be over where the YMCA is, and then they moved it down the Weir. They used to burn coal in order to create the gas down there. This is the Silver City Queen. Mayor Richard Johnson, I was mayor from 82 up to 91. He bought a catamaran with the intent of either for tours or make it a floating restaurant. It was an idea, and it was, but it was so rusty that the plan never came to fruition. We have a call. You're next, an Olde Tyme Taunton.
Hi, Charlie. Extremely interesting show tonight.
Oh, thank you.
I'm just curious. You saw a couple pictures back. You showed of a tugboat that were on the on the river there. Mm-hmm. Is there any historical boating memorabilia, like at the Historical Society or anywhere else in town?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. The Old Colony Historical Society on Church Green has just a wealth of photographs and data relative to not only shipping, but the herring industry that occurred in Taunton. If you're interested in the Taunton River, I urge you, go there. It's open from Tuesday to Saturday, 10 to 4, and we have a trained staff there it'll help you find out whatever you want to find. Because the pictures that I have, I have probably 10,000 pictures in my collection right now, but the museum has thousands and thousands of pictures there, and they're all categorized by rivers or by railroads or by streets or all kinds of things. So if you want to go down and do some research, that's a good place to start.
Okay, thank you. Great. Check it out.
Great, thank you. Definitely worthwhile. What I try to do with these programs, I've been doing, going around the city, promoting the city for 35 years. But now with the, I have a whole dozens and dozens of programs that I do in my computer and do PowerPoint programs, not only like on today, but into a group. Maybe you have a small group that meets from time to time and they're looking for a speaker. I'd be more than happy to do that and show some of these pictures to blow them up the size of a wall so you really can see a lot of things. I don't let them store these pictures in boxes and hide them away. I want to put them on the show so you can see them, and that's where... You know, people, don't throw away any pictures. That's all I urge you. If you don't want the pictures anymore, give them to me, and I'll be able to allow people to see them. This is the old F.B. Rogers. F.B. Rogers was originally the Weir Stove Company, one of several stove companies in town. The Weir Stove Company started about 1874 by William Ellery Walker, George Wilbur, and Charles Baker. And they were the largest stove factory east of Detroit around 1901. And it's now all gone. When they closed in the 40s, 1940s, F.B. Rogers, the Silver Company, moved into it. So this was taken in June of 2009 when we went through and tore all that down. And that's taken from the remaining building there that was part of F.B. Rogers. But I mentioned earlier about the canal. And it was, you must be fibbing. But no, I'm not. This is an official report of a ship canal planned between the Taunton River and Boston Harbor. And this is, it's a wealth of information. You can find it online. If you go into Google Books and type in the canal in Taunton, Mass., up will come this. And you'll see it. And there's all the designs and the gates and all kinds of things about it. But that's just to give you an idea, that just to show you that I wasn't making it up. And there's the tugboat and the schooner towing it up the river. You're next in Olde Tyme Taunton. Hi. You're on the air. Whoops. Well, tell you what. Give us a call. Call us back. Tell us what you know about the Taunton River. And if I'm saying anything that's incorrect, please feel free to tell me. Because I don't profess to be an expert, and I'm not going to be upset if somebody says, no, it was actually a different name or a different date or something like that. So I'm not too proud to have somebody do that, because I learn something every day from doing this. So give us a call here, 774-501-1756. Oh, we have a call here. You're next in Olde Tyme Taunton. Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Hi, you're on the air. If you could turn your TV down, it'll be, you'll get a feedback if you have the TV up. Okay?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
Hold on, I'll be doing it.
Sure. Go ahead.
Yeah, the Taunton River down by the Helen Run called the VFW.
Uh-huh. Say it again, please.
It's
the VFW?
Like, it's like gone now, right?
What is?
The Helen Run. There used to be a tube that ran in between the ponds.
Could you say it again? I'm just having trouble hearing what you said.
There used to be a tube that ran in between from the river into the pond, into the old brickyard.
Okay.
For the Helen Run.
Okay.
Do you know what I'm talking about? Across from the river from the VFW.
A herring. I don't know if a herring run there, but.
There used to be a tube in the Helen Run. They used to run in there, uh-huh. And now the stripers go right in and eat all the herring.
Uh huh.
And all the ponds in the old style of the hot brickyard.
Sure.
Where the Indian pond condominiums are now.
Sure.
All them ponds have a tide.
Well, they would be affected by, because there's a lot of clay in that area, so everything that's feeding into it, sure.
But that tube was there for years. I was a kid going up there, my grandfather, and then they put the condos up there, and now suddenly that looks like that pond got dug right out.
Yeah. Well,
so the river just goes flowing right into the brickyard pond.
Right, in feeding that, sure, because that was the Stiles and Hot, and they eventually were over near, or earlier, were over near County Street, and they eventually moved.
Exactly.
They moved because they kept exhausting the clay. Sure. Oh, yeah, still a lot of bricks all along the river.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So that.
Well, I was talking about the hammer being all chowed up.
Oh, really? Yeah, because that they used to, they couldn't get all the way up. They'd go up through East Taunton.
They go into that tube.
Sure.
And go into the ponds and jump up to the next ponds. And they go to the stream right behind my house.
Sure.
Now they don't even make it because the baths go late in there now.
Sure. Yeah, absolutely. Oh, yeah.
Who do you get in touch with so they can fix that?
The Conservation Commission.
Conservation?
Michelle Restino. And the number I'm drawing a blank off the top of my head, but just call it Taunton Conservation and they know exactly who'll get involved, okay? Great, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Right. We're down at East Taunton, you've got the area where Old Colony Avenue, and you can see where the Battle Row is, but that was a popular spot for fishing, because you can see them all, look at that, with their nets, all gathered, especially around May. April, May is the area when the fish were coming upstream, and this is you can see them bringing in the nets. It was quite a big popular industry. You're next in Olde Tyme Taunton.
Yes, I was wondering how Moorage Bridge got its name, because there's a plaque on it. It was built in 1930.
Well, there's always been a bridge there from probably very, very early 1800s. It's actually, I believe, they call it Moorage Bridge, but I think it more accurately is Maori. Mowry, the gentleman who lived right next to it, because it was always Maury's Bridge at White's Dam, and there was a gentleman named White who lived on the east side of the bridge, and a guy named Maury, M R W M-O-W-R-Y, who lived on the other side. So I think that's probably, it just evolved over the years. But that was put in as a means to dam up the river to create a man-made pond called Scatting Pond that ultimately became Sebatia Lake.
Okay, but I was wondering how it got into the name Morey's.
Yeah, after the family lived right next to it. That's
okay.
That's how, okay?
Thank you.
Yeah. But you can see how the big net that they had here, and then this is in Taunton River, along near Dean Street, and then they would pull it in. They'd reel in that along with the fish. See, those are the big wheels that would pull in the net. And what we're going to show you, see, look, a lot of people involved in the industry. It was a very, very big industry here at one time. But look at the fish coming in. This is in Taunton River. They'd bring in the fish by bushels. So you can see this is in Taunton, Mass., the herring industry. Wouldn't you like to see that come back? This is one of my favorite pictures. A good day, a good summer day, is a young boy with a dog and his dog and a full catch. His mother's going to be proud when he brought that home. But this is the old Colony Ironworks down where, as you cross near where the Mayfair used to be, in East Taunton, between the line of Rainham and so forth. That's the front entrance of the Herring Run. This is the season pass for 1928. Teddy Roosevelt came there. Upon visiting in 1912. But that's the dam, and the herring could not jump up that dam. It was too high. So that's why they created over to the left a series of fish ladders. And that's the fish ladder that allowed them to jump up. Very, very famous. People would come on Sundays, for example, by the dozens and dozens of people would come there to visit. As you can see, this is looking down the ladder at the river, and they would come up. But now we're going over to because we only have about 20 minutes left, the Mill River. And these numbers, this is the center of town where the Mill River is. See, all those numbers correspond with a mill that was on the Mill River. So these are all, this is the legend to that. All the different mills on the Mill River in Taunton, the center of town. So I'm going to show you. Right there, that's where the first real mill was in 1649. That's right in near the center of town. Then you've got up here, that's where the first sawmill, and that would be right around near Redenbaden, Danforth Street. Then you've got an area up here where the Whittington Mills, the first ironworks. That's right where Warren, at the corner of Warren and Whittington Street is. Then you've got the Hopewell Ironworks, that would be behind After Hours Auto Body over near Danforth Street. Then you've got the Adams Slitting Mill, that is right near near Danforth Street, near the back of Taunton State Hospital. Then you get Tisdale Slitting Mill. That's more down where near where the Gazette is. Then you get the Slitting Mill up here. That's also up where near Redenbarton is. Then you got a nail shop, and that's right where near Washington Street, near Park Street. Then you got the Green Mill, that's right near where the TMLP is. You got Hopewell Mill, that's a textile mill. That's actually right between After Hours Auto Body and Hopewell Park. They call it the Taunton State Hospital Dam, but it was for the Hopewell Mill. There's the Cobb Iron Works and Brick Mill. That would be right near the Gazette on Court Street, because Court Street was called Cobb's Lane for many years. Calico Print Works, that's also right in the center of town where the Mill River is. And then Albertfield Tack Works, that's on Spring Street. That's where the brick apartment house is today. And then you've got Crocker's Foundry Machine Company, that's right on Court Street, right where the parking lot is, across from the Boys Club. And you get the Taunton Britannia Manufacturing Company, and that is basically Redenbarton. How it's called. There you got White Manufacturing Company. That is right where Whittington Mills is, and near Warren, and the manufacturing company there too. The Cohanet Mills. That's right where near Chandler Avenue. Over near actually Cohanet Mill would be actually where Rennie's Curtain Factory over there, where Coyle Cassidy is. Hopewell Mills, the mills as well over in that area. Then you've got the Canoe Mills. That's over where Chandler Avenue and Hodges Avenue. Then you get the Mason Machine Works, not technically on the river, but that's where the Bloom Bus Station is. Then the Taunton Locomotive Works. That's right where the old mall is, where the actual dialysis center is and the Registry of Motor Vehicles. And, of course, the Taunton Light Plant. That's right on the river as well. But all those were businesses that benefited from the Mill River, and that's why it got its name. There's the YMCA. That's where the river where that bridge is now, the walking bridge, going to the parking lot. That'll show you where the one of the earliest mills in town. Here, this shows you right on Court Street, near the British block, where a lot of the British immigrants came and worked in the mills. That's right behind the Gazette, right in that area, just to orient yourself. And the Lincoln, there was actually Lincoln and the person who lived there, and then also Robert Crossman. And he lived in this house. And you say, well, that doesn't look like a house. It looks like a garage. But look at it. That's that's where Harry Bloom used to fix his buses across the street from the YMCA. But that's what it looked like. See? That's the same house. That's what it looked like before it was made into a garage. And I mentioned the flood earlier over on Summer Street. This is that same flood of February of 1886 behind the Gazette. The building you see to the right is right where the Taunton Daily Gazette parking lot is, just to orient yourself. Germany Cleaners would be on the left. That's where the Gazette, the old Gazette building was. I mentioned behind After Hours Auto Body, this is the dam that was the actual Hopewell Mill Dam. Sometimes people today call it the Taunton State Hospital Dam, but it's actually the Hopewell Mill Dam. There's the Hopewell Mill right on the Mill River. But that's in the process of being torn down. Then you've got Reed and Barton, source of employment for a lot of people, the granddaddy of all industry along the river. They had water power. This is that same flood of 1886. Then that's some of the damage that was done by the trolley cars. Those are the tracks that you see there. But that is Reed and Barton, silversmiths, the oldest active industry still in town. But the reason I show you this is where it's in Whittington. So we're going to the Whittington, up in the Whittington area where the old ironworks used to be. But this is in Staffordshire, England. And you'll see that area right there, it's Whittington. That's where the Leonard family had their forge. And so when they built the Taunton Ironworks in what was Taunton, that area later became Rainham. When they built their second ironworks, they couldn't call it the Taunton Ironworks, so they called it after their family industry, which was the Whittington Forge, and that's where it got its name, Whittington Manufacturing. Yeah, that red block is at the corner of Warren and Whittington Street, and that is where the first ironworks, or the second ironworks in town. And the area, that road that you see going up to the left, that's the old Whittington Street that went by the old Pepper Pot. And that was a towpath, where they would pick up the raw material that was up further upstream and bring it to the raw iron ore all around where Sebastian Lake is now. Before the lake was there, they used to mine the iron ore and bring it down that path to get to the mill. And eventually they flooded it all in. That's the Whittington Mills. It's a flea market. That's where they're going to renovate, hopefully, real very soon, and put all kind of apartments and other actions in there. It's Willard Lovering, William, Charles, and Henry Lovering. Those were his sons on the bottom. They created the Whittington Manufacturing Company. But this shows you, that's the industry to the right, but you can see the mill pond that's there. That's the Whittington Mill Pond. The pond was created because of the old Whittington Dam that's right there. And that was built around 1832. That's the one, this is the dam that made Bob Nunes famous. Former Mayor Bob Nunes, it's the problem that he had with this dam gave rise to that crisis, and ultimately he did such a good job coordinating that effort that the governor recognized it and got him a job in Boston. But that's overlooking it. I was on the ladder, the fire department ladder, looking at that. And then they put these pile of rocks in afterwards. That's the aftermath of that. And that's all going to be cleared away in order for the herring to get further upstream. That's Sam Crocker. Sam Crocker, Charles Richmond, and Thomas Bush, they were all the ones who gave rise or initiated the installation of the dams on the Mill River. That's Maury's. It's called Maury's, but on the left is where the Maury family lived, and White family lived on the other side, because it was always Maury's Bridge at White's Dam, or White's Dam at Maury's Bridge. That's all in the process of being renovated, a new bridge being installed, and a new dam. And that's looking over the bridge at the old gatehouse. That's the boathouse that was just below Maury's Bridge. The boathouse is no longer there, but this is no longer there either. But that's what they tore it out a few years ago. But that's what it looked like inside. And those wooden slats that you see, you'd pull those block and tackle, would lift up the gates in order to let the water through. And they had done repairs in the 50s of that particular gatehouse. But the lake was also used for ice, and there were gatehouses all across on the river near the gondola, and they also had them over other parts of the river of the lake as well. And when the water was real low about 10 years ago, up on the Snake River beyond Scatting Street is where these stone circles. There's several of them, and that's where when the fish would be able to come up here, they would take a wrong turn and go into this, what basically a cul-de-sac, and they'd block it off, and that's how the Native Americans used to catch the fish. The Three Mile River, or sometimes called the Nissequehannock River, the people of the Two Stone Water Place, that's what it allegedly means. But just to show you where the Three Mile River, you can see where it says Winthrop Street. Then you've got North Walker Street going up. Rocky Wood Street would be up there. South Walker Street, you can see identified. But just to show you the area, right there is where the Westfield Mill used to be. If you come out North Walker Street, look straight across. That's where Westfield Mill used to be. But then you've got the area as you're looking up, going towards the center there, is where, as you're going towards Fisher Street. And you've got the fairgrounds is where Fairfax Gardens, and to the left, upper left of that, is where the golf course is. But that's the river at the time when this is the Westfield Mill. It's what it looked like, a textile mill. It's a source of employment for a lot of people in the Westfield area. Also on that site is where the anchor for the USS Constitution was forged. This tablet is still found on the bridge. Even though they renovated the bridge, they put this tablet back. Hadijah Bayless, a soldier in the Revolution, but he also ran a bloomery or a iron forge there. The anchor for the USS Constitution. This is the river as you go down beyond the Boyd and Wildlife Sanctuary behind Devine's Farm or Reed's Farm. This is the Arthur C. Bent cabin at Boyden. There he is. He was a Tauntonian, served on the city council, and later became a world-renowned expert on birds. There's the Boyden Wildlife Sanctuary. She was one of the, Gertrude Boyden was one of the first chairmen of the Conservation Commission. A beautiful place. A lot of people still go there to walk. This area, that's where the Westville Conservation Area. This was a Native American village, that site, for 10,000 years. These are some of the artifacts that were found there. This has been authenticated by Dr. Hoffman at the Bridgewater State College. Had a hollowed out, looks like a potato skin. It's all iron in there, and this rock. And they would pull it out and and mixed with grease would create the red paint that the Wampanoags would use to paint the faces. And that, look at that, that's one of the pieces they would carve out to use as a weapon. This is the Willis Cave right at Fisher Street with the bicycle bandit. It's all filled in now, but that's his cave. This is where Oakland Mill used to be. That's actually near Oakland Variety with the Bob Studley Bridge. And then you got the Oakland Mill, textile mill. This is inside the thing. I'm just hurrying along because we're running out of time. And that's the, and then you've got another mill. This is over on Short Street, and you can see in the center, just north of the center, that's Country Way that comes off of Norton Avenue. And that's, there we go, we'll identify everything. Country Way, and that's Mill Lane, Paper Street now. But that's where this mill used to be, the Wooded Mills. Josiah and Fred Wooded, and there used to be a road that went right across here. There was a sawmill on one side. This was the box mill, and there was a sawmill on the other side. These are some of the millstones that are found nearby, right there, right at the end of Country Way. If you're ever going up 140, you'll see this house. This is the Wooded family home. But you can see how the whole place has changed. And this is Wooded Spring. It's the oldest park other than Taunton Green. It's on Harvey Street and at Three Mile River. There's the ladles. And you'd go up all the way. You get the stairway up to the plateau where they have a concession stand, gazebo. Have a place for dancing, and there they are, the tilts. There they have dancing. Very picturesque. And we'll just end with the scene of the river here. Whoops. What we've seen is some of the rivers in Taunton. I hope you enjoyed a look at some of the Taunton rivers. Like any program that I have a PowerPoint program on dozens and dozens of topics. Railroads or trolley cars or old houses, Christmas City, famous people, all the neighborhoods. I've done pictures of it, famous, you know, old houses, the Plain Cemetery, Mount Pleasant Cemetery, Camp Miles Standish, dozens and dozens of programs. Any organization that would like me to speak before them and show this, just let me know. Contact the museum or contact... I won't give my home number right off the phone here, but contact City Hall. They still know how to get in touch with me. And it's volunteer. There's no charge for anybody to do that. So I enjoy doing it. I'm convinced the more you know about Taunton, the more you love it. My family's been here for 13 generations, and I'm very, very proud of it. So I hope you are too. So join us next week on another edition of Olde Tyme Taunton. Thank you and good night. We'll be right back.